Now listen, from the trailer that we've seen, it does look like Christine Quinn is in for another rough season. Poor thing.
So Emma is basically taking Christine's desk?
Wow.
I hope you see it as a professional decision.
How did it get to be that way for her again?
You know, I think at this point she's made her bed, and I, you know, yeah. It's, you know.
I said poor thing, and you looked at me like,
I just think, you know, after so long working with people, you know, I think people have just had enough. And I think that's nice to kind of, you know, sometimes you gotta address it.
Yeah.
So that you can move forward. And I'm sure the fans will love to see us do that.
I like what you said though. I've seen a couple episodes, and I think it was in the first episode, you were just playing with it. You were like, listen, we're not friends. And it's okay to just not be friends sometimes.
I think it's better to just own it. And, yeah. You know, sometimes, you know, I used to try and talk around it. It is what it is.
Exactly.
I don't think we're trying to fool anybody here.
Okay, so the season ends with a really bizarre series of confrontations with Christine.
I would love to talk to you. What's happened is that you have lied and done things to each person individually. And then you come up with a story with that person, and then you lie.
Okay.
And if you want to talk to someone, then talk to all of us. Because it's happened to all of us, and I'm over it.
Is there any chance that she can be part of this group moving forward, or is it just too broken? Is this the end?
You know, I have to say, I think at the end of the day, nobody wants a situation where it's everyone against one at all. I think what everyone is really looking for is some accountability. And just, you know, saying, listen, I've done this, I'm sorry, and let's move forward. Mm-hmm. That, until that happens, I think we're all kind of at a standstill because things are being done, and yet it's like, oh, you know, let's not harp on it, you know, but it's like, we haven't harped on it. You've yet to admit that these things that you're doing, please stop, and please say, you know, yeah, I did it.
But there's part of me that feels like she likes being the villain. She likes this. she relishes it a little bit.
Yeah, oh, for sure. I mean, she has two sides to her personality. There's that side that's like, definitely like you said, mm-hmm. but then there's that other side where, you know, all of a sudden it's like, well, now I feel bad because we're, you know, and
exactly,
she's like, you know, the totally opposite, and she, you know, but it's just, you know, frustrating. Mm-hmm. I hope that we can get to a place where she can just take accountability. We can all move on. I think the last thing we want to do is, you know, just beat this dead horse.
Absolutely.
Been dead.
Absolutely. So what do you make of her saying that you all are the mean girls and that you all froze her out?
I mean, it's honestly, to me, ridiculous just mm-hmm. because, again, I've known these girls a long time. It just takes the smallest bit of effort. One, to stop doing the stuff that she's doing.
Right.
But also just say, you know, hey, I did that. And I was pissed off, and here's why I did it. So, you know, and even if you don't apologize, just honestly anything. But it's hard to work with nothing. And so everyone's just kind of gotten to a place where the bridges have been burned. There's been no effort to fix it. And so.
And it's just done. Gotcha.
What do you do?
Do you feel any differently when you watch back some of the moments that you weren't present with her? Like when she just had the baby, there was, you know, a scene with her and Amanda, and she got really emotional because she did have an emergency C-section.
Yeah.
It was a you know, rough go for her.
Yeah.
So do you look at her any differently when you look back at some things like that?
I mean, that's the thing is, you know, I feel like if she could be that person to any of us mm-hmm. instead of, you know, the side that she is, you know, with me personally, it would go a long way. I never see that side of her.
Right.
I watch it as if it's a new person that I have not known. So I feel for her. And of course I wish, you know, that I could see that side to her.
When Mary said she did not even accept the gift when she sent her assistant, she didn't even accept the baby gift. I was like, ooh, girl, that's harsh.
Yeah.
That is harsh. That is so harsh. Can we talk about that Davina apology moment? Awkward.
Oh my gosh, it was awkward.
Jez, I'm really sorry for hurting your feelings, genuinely, and that was not my intention. It was just a thoughtless comment that was offensive, and I'm sorry for hurting your feelings. I really am.
Okay, I appreciate that. I would have appreciated it.
Sure.
You know, it's been like a long time, so it would have been a little more genuine if you'd said it before.
It is genuine.
So where do you two stand going into season 5?
So, you know, we have to same thing. We have to have that conversation so that we can just move past. And we do, and it's awkward. But then, you know, I feel like, you know, it's the kind of thing where we're not best friends or anything like that, but we at least now can have a respect with each other going forward. And I think that's where we go into season 5, is there's a mutual respect. And now, you know, I think that's even gone further than that, which is nice, because it just takes, you know, if both people make an effort, let's please just, you know, put the petty stuff behind us. If both people are making the same effort, I have no issue with someone. And so we've actually been able to do that. So you'll see, it took a journey to get there, though.
Yeah, I mean, you've had quite a journey, too. And I have to say, like, you look like you're in a great place. Like, the smile is so bright. But think about, like, where you were just a short while ago, and look at you now.
I know.
Buying your own dream house, you found love again, you're doing so well in your job, like all these great things.
Thank you so much, it means a lot. I'm very happy, I feel very fortunate, and I think when really terrible things happen to you, it actually helps you soak in those good moments even more, because you don't take them for granted.
Yeah.
And so that's what I feel like I'm doing. I know it's amazing, but I'm reminding myself at every moment how great.
I gotcha.